What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Full 90. It is time for the Week 6 Premier League predictions. Once again, here all the winning accumulated over on the Patreon, but I just want to say we're doing another giveaway because you guys appreciated the last one so much. We gave away $100 to a random member from the Patreon at the start of the season to kick things off. I'll be doing it again, this time with $50. So if you want a chance to win that, then all you got to do is join the Patreon. And once again, I want to highlight, I mean, these two Akkas here, 40 odd to 1, just combined, phenomenal stuff. Now, as I said in the last video, I am having to pre-record this, so I don't actually know the results from week 5. I don't even know some of the Champions League results, so just bear with me, but I'm actually away from home for the week, and if I didn't record it today, I wouldn't be able to get this video out for you all. I'll still be posting tips and stuff over on Patreon from my phone, so you're all good there, but in terms of making this video, I don't have the hindsight that you guys do when watching it. But nevertheless, let's kick it off with Newcastle up against Manchester City. If we go back to the week before, I predicted that Man City would beat Arsenal. This is great. I'm going to say what I predicted and you guys get ultimate hindsight. And I predicted that Newcastle would actually drop a point to Fulham. I think Newcastle could and should win that, but I could see Fulham getting something. You guys will know. This is probably going to be so exciting for you because I always love watching prediction videos with the hindsight that the people in the videos don't have. So you guys know how week 5 went. I don't. But I do think Man City, after, in my opinion, beating Arsenal at the Etihad, I think they're going to go to St. James's Park and beat Newcastle. I'm going to go for Man City to win 2-1, and the tip is going to be Man City to win at 1.7. After this, it's Arsenal up against Leicester. Now, I don't even know if Arsenal, how they got on against Atalanta yet. That hasn't happened either. So, Arsenal, I don't have a lot to really give in terms of up-to-date information. Like I said, I think they're going to miss out against Manchester City and lose. I think Leicester can get a point from Everton, but I'm going to go for Arsenal to bounce back to winning ways here with a 3-0 win. I don't know if Odegaard will be back by this time. It's in a couple of weeks, so I don't know. But 3-0 is going to be the scoreline, and the tip is going to be Arsenal half-time, Arsenal full-time at 1.57. Afterwards, we move on to Brentford up against West Ham. Brentford in week 5 would have played Tottenham. I predicted they lost 2-1, and West Ham, they would have played Chelsea, and I predict that they will finally lose to Chelsea at the London Stadium. But this is going to be very entertaining, a little London derby. I think both teams are going to score. I think it's going to be high scoring, so I'm going to split the difference and go for a 2-2 draw between the two teams, and the tip is going to be both teams to score and over 2.5 goals. After this, it's going to be Chelsea up against Brighton. I think Chelsea are going to be going from strength to strength. I predicted them to beat West Ham, and Brighton, I predicted them to actually beat Nottingham Forest, which I'm not super confident on. I could see that being a draw. I could see Forest even getting a result, but I'm going to go for a crazy scoreline here. I'm going to go for Chelsea to win this one 4-2, and I'm going to be honest, I'm just going to throw out a goal scorer there. I'm going to say Nicholas Jackson will score one of the goals. I just had a thought this morning that Jackson was going to score soon, and he might very well have done last week against West Ham, and that's what this thought would have been about, because that hasn't happened for me yet, but for you, you will know. So did Jackson score against West Ham? If he did, that's where this feeling's come from. And if he didn't, I think it'll happen against Brighton. Chelsea 4, Brighton 2. And I'm going to go for a high odds tip here. Chelsea to win and both teams to score at 3.2. After this, it is Everton up against Crystal Palace. In the previous game week, I actually predicted that Palace could get something from Manchester United and Everton can get their first point of the season. But this one is just a pure gut feeling. I'm going to go for Everton to get their first win of the season at Goodison Park. I know. I think Palace are a better team. I think they're better organised. I think they've had a better start to the season, of course. They've got better players. And nothing points to an Everton win except my gut feeling. And obviously, Everton are going to win a game this season. So why not now? So I'm going to go for Everton to win 1-0. And the tip is Everton double chance at 1.5. Again, Palace could totally win. Everton could lose to Leicester, lose to Palace. But like I said, they're going to win at some point. And at home to Palace, why not? So I'll go against what I assume most people predict. I think a lot of people, this is way ahead of time, because obviously I've not seen a single week 6 prediction video. I've barely seen any week 5 videos, but I think a lot of people will probably predict this to be a 1-1 draw or maybe a 2-1 Palace win, but I'm going to shade it to Everton. After this, Nottingham Forest up against Fulham. As I said earlier, I said that I think Forest might struggle against Brighton away from home, and I think Fulham can get a good point against Newcastle. I think this has 1-1 written all over it, so I'm going to go for 1-1. The tip is both teams to score at 1.7. I think if I go to my correct score predictions so far this season, And this is just tipped correct scores, not even in the videos. We've got a fair few 1-1s. We have a 1-1 with Forest and Wolves that I predicted, and a 1-1 with Fulham and West Ham that I predicted. So I've correctly predicted that both of these teams draw 1-1 already this season. I'm going to double up and say it'll happen again. Nottingham Forest 1, Fulham 1. After this, it's Wolverhampton Wanderers up against Liverpool. Previous game week, I predicted that Wolves would lose to Aston Villa. I'm very, very confident on that. And I did, of course, predict that Liverpool would beat Bournemouth. And I do think Bournemouth might be able to score at Anfield. So I think I'm going to be spot on there. I think Wolves would have lost last week, and I think Liverpool would have won last week. And I'm going to say the same again. Liverpool 2 win at Molineux, 2-0. Wolves really struggling to score. I think Liverpool can win with a clean sheet, but the tip is going to be Liverpool minus one handicap at 2.05. After this, it's Ipswich up against Aston Villa. Ipswich, if you discount their results against Liverpool and Manchester City, they've had a pretty decent season. They obviously recently drew with Brighton, and I also predicted that they'd be able to get at least a draw from Southampton. I think Southampton should be able to beat Ipswich at home, but I think Ipswich maybe snuck a little draw. And Ipswich obviously did the double over Southampton in the Championship last year. So I think they have a chance to get a point there. However, I don't see it happening against Aston Villa, who not only did I predict to beat Young Boys in the Champions League, and they did, I predicted to beat Wolves, and I assume by this point they will have done, barring any upset. I think Villa can win this one here, and I love the odds for this one. So I'm going to go for Aston Villa to win this one 3-1. And the tip, Aston Villa at 1.85. I'm surprised this wasn't like 1.7. So 1.85, I'm taking that right now. It might get a little bit shorter by the time this video comes out, as more people see the odds and pile in. These odds are very fresh. I don't think many people will be betting on these games right now and influencing the odds or anything, because everyone's focused on game week 5. So I think if you can get in on Aston Villa at 1.85, I think that's only going to get shorter as we get closer to kickoff. So I think Villa will win there. After this, this is one of the games of the week. It's Manchester United up against Tottenham Hotspur, and I found this one really difficult to call. Tottenham had a dramatic late comeback in the League Cup to see our double of Tottenham and both teams to score, and Brighton to win, and over 1.5 goals in the League Cup to come in. Man United beat Barnsley 7-0. Previous game week, I predicted Tottenham would beat Brentford, and I predicted that Man United would drop points away at Selhurst Park. This is a really difficult one to call. I think Tottenham will give them a good game. I actually just can't separate the two teams, whether it was in my league predictions at the start of the season where I predicted they'd finish next to each other in the table, or in the head-to-head games. I just can't separate them. You never know who's going to turn up. Man United, I think it's more likely Tottenham show up and randomly win 3-0 than Man United doing that. But Man United could easily win this game as well. So I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw. And I struggle to find value, honestly. So I've just gone both teams to score at 1.36. The odds are awful, but they're awful because I think it's likely. So 1-1 draw, both teams to score 1.36. And the final game of the game week, the South Coast Derby, I guess you could call it. Bournemouth up against Southampton. So as I said last game week, I've predicted Southampton finally get at least a point on the board from Ipswich. Can they double up and get some points here? I'm actually going to go with Bournemouth. I like what Bournemouth have been doing this season, and I'm going to go for a 2-1 win to the Cherries, and my tip is going to be both teams to score and over 2.5 goals at 1.83. I think if I had to predict the tips that I most like the look of, it would probably be both teams to score on over 2.5 goals in the Brentford West Ham game, Aston Villa to win away at Ipswich, Liverpool to win away at Wolves. I think those are some really good ones. The ones I'm not so sure on are probably the likes of Everton double chance. I think that's a bit of a risky one. And if there's one more I could pick out, honestly, I don't know. I mean, I like the tips. Maybe both teams scoring over 2.5 goals in the Bournemouth game, because that does rely on Southampton. Chelsea and both teams to score, albeit high odds, I think it's very likely. I really do. So I like the looks of all of these fixtures. Thank you so much for watching the Week 6 Premier League predictions, for all your support on YouTube here, over on Patreon as well. I really do appreciate it. And like I said, if you want to get involved with not only the exclusive tips and accumulators, but for a chance to win $50 this month, then you can join. It's only $9.99, so if you win, you get that back and more. And of course, we are well over 100 units in profit for the accumulators as well. So it's all good over there on the Patreon. Thank you so much for the support, and I will see you in the next video very soon. I can't wait to read the comments on this one. All the hindsight you have that I don't, it's going to be hilarious.